Good evening, boys and girls. Welcome to Candy's Cozy Couch. My name is Candace, and my nickname is Candy. That's how I came up with that really decorated name. At least I think it's pretty decorated. Oh, well, the name might be decorated, but my door is decorated. I did some Christmas decorating, and so I decorated my door. Yeah, that's it. That's what I wanted to say. Anyway, boys and girls, you know what time it is. It's time for the checklist. 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 Just like this. So here we go. Have you had your baths or showers yet? Check. You have your PJs on? Check. Did you brush your teeth? Are they all shiny and gleaming and white with breath all fresh? Check. Did you put on your nightlight? Got a nightlight? Check. Did you do your homework? Hope your homework's done. Check. What about your room? Is your room clean? Did you clean your room? Check. Are you snug as a bug in a rug under your blanket in your bed? Check. Did you give your I love yous and your hugs, kisses, and smooches to your family members and pets in the house? Check. And of course, the most important one. Did you say your prayers? If you did not say your prayers before you go to sleep, make sure that you do that. All right, that's golf. We got the checklist done. Anything else extra, make sure you check it off your list before we get going. There's a book for you. It's Christmas themed, so I'm rolling with the Christmas. It's a Disney book. I don't get to watch much Disney, but Phineas and Ferb, is that how you say it? Oh, Christmas Tree. And this is actually a sticker book. That's cool. It's from the hit TV series on Disney. So I'll just show you. On the back it says, Dashing Through the Snow. It's Christmas Eve and Phineas and Ferb have just learned that Danville's 50-foot prize evergreen was destroyed in a freak accident, which means no tree lighting ceremony. So the stepbrothers and their friends head into the mountains to find a new tree. But little does the gang know that the evil Dr. Doofenshmirtz, is plotting to make sure no Christmas festival happens. Will their trip be a success, or will this be the unmerriest Christmas ever? Huh. Well, we're about to find out, I guess. I hope I don't have to say that name, though, the evil person. Oh, Christmas Tree. Here we go. It was Christmas Eve, and Phineas and Ferb were waiting for the town celebration to begin. But the mayor had bad news. The annual lighting of the Christmas tree is canceled. Our prize evergreen was destroyed in a freak accident, he said. Ferb, Phineas exclaimed. I know what we're going to do today. We're going to find the perfect tree. Okay. Phineas and Ferb's older sister, Candace, hey, and she spells it just like me, overheard her brother. I have to find out what Phineas is up to, she thought. Later on, Phineas and Ferb's friends stopped by. What you doing? Isabel asked Phineas, building a souped-up, rocket-powered, all-terrain, evergreen-detecting super sleigh, Phineas told her. Okay. Well, we're about to see. Soon, the sleigh was ready, and the friends jumped inside. Everybody ready to go? Phineas asked. Hey, where's Perry? He asked, looking around. Meanwhile, Perry, the platypus, a.k.a. Agent P was heading into his secret lair, it was time to find out his assignment for the day. Hello, Agent P. Major Monogram Perry's supervisor officer said, Dr. Doofenshmirtz, oh my goodness, is behind the destruction of Danville's Christmas tree. You must find out what he's up to. Phoenix and the gang were about to leave when Candace burst into the backyard. Not so fast, you two, she said. But Phoenix couldn't hear her over the loud engine as they started to speed away. Candace lost her balance and fell into a snow tube attached to the sleigh. Well, I guess you'll be coming along for the ride. That's what it looks like. The group traveled up into the mountain in search of the perfect tree. The sleigh changed into a snowmobile to climb the steep hills. Candace was traveling behind them unnoticed. Suddenly, the sleigh came to a screeching halt. Uh-oh, the trail is too narrow for the sleigh, Isabel said. We'll go on foot, Phoenix told them. Oh, yeah. You sure it's safe to be out here all alone? Buford asked. We're not alone, Isabel replied. Phoenix is here. Then all of a sudden, a large snarling yeti jumped out. Buford stammered. That's the abominable snowman. Beljeet corrected him. Everyone screamed. What? Y'all see that? Oh man, it's going down. Getting kind of interesting. Meanwhile, at the top of the very same mountain, Dr. Doofenshmirtz was preparing his latest evil invention. Just then, Agent P sailed in on a hang glider. Huh. The doctor quickly trapped Perry in a cage. Behold, Dr. Doofenshmirtz cried, my snow hurl herf inator. Is that what that's called? My snow herf inator? Wow. I am going to use it to make a fool of my brother Roger, the mayor, by hurling a giant snowball onto the town square. Really? This story is getting a little goofy, guys. Let's keep going. Down the mountain, the Yeti was approaching Phoenix. What are we going to do? Isabel cried. Don't worry, Phoenix said. He doesn't want to hurt us. Right, Ferb said in agreement. Yetis are vegetarians, and they rarely show aggression unless they feel threatened. Phoenix turned to the Yeti. We only came for one special tree, and we brought seeds to plant in its place, he said. The Yeti smiled. Okay. The Yeti might be eating spaghetti, if I can turn this page. Here we go. Soon the group was playing together like old friends. They played freeze tag, made snow angels, and built snowmen. Candace, however, was not having any fun. She had run into icy rocks, prickly thorns, and hissing raccoons. "I'll get you, Phoenix," she muttered. It was time for Phoenix and Ferb to get back to their mission. "Hey, Mr. Yeti," Phoenix said, where can we find a giant tree?" The Yeti pointed to a beautiful evergreen in the distance. "That's it," Phoenix shouted. The Yeti yanked the giant tree from the ground. Isabel and Buford planted the seeds. "Danville's celebration is going to be saved," Phoenix explained. "Oh, okay. Well, that'll be good if that's the case." Okay. Make sure I'm not skipping pages here. Atop the mountain, Dr. Doofenshmirtz was about to fire his snowball. His snow hurlinator, oh my goodness, into the center of town. Just then, Perry broke free and leaped at the doctor. But Dr. Doofenshmirtz used his snow hurlinator to pummel the platypus with endless snowballs. "In 5 more seconds, Danville's celebration will be ruined," the doctor yelled. What? It's getting really interesting. Time was running out. Perry grabbed a snowball and threw it at the snow hurlinator. It hit the controls just as the invention fired. Then a gigantic snowball flew high into the sky in the wrong direction. Further down the hill, Candace saw her brother in the distance. They are so busted, she said, heading towards them. Just then, the massive snowball landed behind Candace and rolled after her. Uh-oh. Oh, no. What is going on? The tumbling snowball picked up Candace as it rolled down the hill. It stopped near Phoenix and the group, blocking the sled and their view of Candace. "Hop onto the tree, everyone," Phoenix shouted. He waved to the Yeti. "Thanks for your help." At the last second, Candace jumped on the tree trunk and held on for dear life. Whoosh! The friends slid down the snow-covered mountain, riding the giant tree like a mighty bobsled. So they're just going to ride the tree in, huh? That's what we're doing. That's what we doing. Okay. That's what we doing. As the tree sped into town, it picked up decorations and other things along the way. "We're almost there, everyone," Phoenix yelled. "Hooray!" The gang cheers. Oh, okay. A self-decorating tree. It was like, while I'm on the way, let me pick up decorations. Okay. Back in Danville, everyone was shocked to see a giant tree heading right for them. Thwack! The tree hit the edge of the stage and tossed the gang safely into the crowd. The town folk cheered. Mom, Candace screamed, did you see Phineas and Ferb brought that giant tree? But her mom's back was to the stage. Candace, how could your brother ever have moved a tree this big? I think maybe you've been out in the cold too long, she said. Aw. Dang. Aw, poor Candace. Back on the mountain, Dr. Doofenshmirtz turned to reload his invention, only to find that Perry had destroyed it. Curse you, Perry the platypus, he howled, his angry voice setting off a huge avalanche that carried him away. Oh, wow. Perry snowboarded towards the party in Danville. Christmas mission accomplished. Dun, 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 dun. Well, I'll be. That was quite an interesting story. And here are the stickers that come with the book. So it came with stickers. Yay. The end. All right, well, they had some doozy of some names up in there. They had me kind of almost stuttering there. All right, boys and girls. Now, there's something you can dream about, a Christmas adventure of your own. Simply close your eyes, whisper to yourself what you would like to dream about. Relax your body, lay still, get comfy and cozy in your bed. Quiet your mind, allow yourself to drift off to sleep. And dream your special dream. With that being said, boys and girls, I'll see you next time.